A blessed Sunday to each and every one of you, and thank you once again for joining us this morning in our live stream. And before we start singing praises to our Lord, let me read to you from Ephesians 5, starting verse 18. And I'll be reading from Isuriwarai Translation. Sabi po dito, ayaw ka mo paghubog hinbino, kay makakaraot laini ha iyo, lugod, mapulo ka mo ha spirito. Pagyakan ka mo ha kada usahin, mga pulongkan, mga salmo, mga himno, ngan mga spiritahon ng mga karantahon. Pagkanta ka mo hin mga himno, ngan mga salmo ha Ginoo, nga may ada pagdayaw ha iyo mga kasing-kasing. Pagpasalamat ka mo pirmi ha Dios nga Ama, tungod hangat tanan, nga mga butang, hangaran han atong Ginoo nga Heso Kristo. And today I want you to continue to open up your heart as we start singing praises to our Lord.
Thank you. thank you very much for joining us this wonderful blessed Sunday. I'm Brother Ryan, and again, tunay pong kinagagalak po namin na makasama po kayo and you joining us, spending your time watching these videos. Last week, we had a great time opening our Bibles and learning from the scriptures that in this season of being in the wilderness, God still speaks. That we can listen to His voice and that He can bring guidance to us, especially in this season. Now, we have learned in the past that if we base our happiness on the wrong things, like, for example, material things, especially in this season, we will be discouraged. If we base our happiness in money, we will be discouraged. If we base our happiness in fame, if we base our happiness in being around friends, especially in this quarantine season, we will be discouraged. Brothers and sisters, we need to put our faith in the written word of God, read our Bibles, and to expect God to speak to us, especially when we focus our hearts and our attention on Him. Now, we will be learning, opening our hearts today, and reading from a chapter in the book of Psalms. Ito po ay ang chapter 27. And before we proceed, we need to learn who is the author of chapter 27. We learn that it is King David. Now, King David is just like you and me. He started as a shepherd boy. Now, nagsimula po siya ng maliit lamang, hindi po siya galing sa linya ng mga hari. He never was a part of that lineage. But from being a shepherd boy, then he became a part of Saul's army. And then he became a captain, a leader in that army. And he became, eventually, the king of Israel. Now, we can understand po that in the life of King David, he is not a perfect person. Now, we can document here the dumpusa sa Bible the times that King David had sinned. So he is not a perfect person. So in conclusion po, we can determine that we do not need to be perfect when we listen to God's voice. We do not need to be perfect when we desire to have more of God in our lives, to seek God in our lives. Rich and poor alike, in this season of being in the wilderness, experience the same things. Experience hardship, experience trouble. But how does a believer like King David fine-tune his thoughts and move forward and, continue to live, continue to thrive in this season? So let's open up our Bibles and let's start off reading Psalms 27. But I'm gonna read it in the Tagalog version po, ang salita ng Diyos. So please follow with me. Ang Panginoon ang aking ilaw at tagapagligtas, sino ang aking katatakutan? Siya ang nagtatanggol sa akin, kaya wala akong dapat katakutan. Now, David knew what he was feeling deep inside. Alam po niya kung ano po yung nararamdaman niya. And he never hid it. He was very honest about what he felt. He felt fear. So it's normal to feel afraid. It's normal to be afraid, especially of things that you do not understand. You can feel afraid if there are things that are out of control in your life. But we cannot stay in an emotional state of being fearful. As a believer, we need to turn from being fearful to being faithful. Ulitin ko po ulit. We need to be faithful. From being fearful to being faithful. Moving on to the second verse. Kapag sinasalakay ako ng masasamang tao o ng aking mga kaaway upang patayin, sila ang nabubuwal at natatalo. Now, even in this season of being in the wilderness, brothers and sisters, bad people will continue to do bad things. David knew that they will not change. They will continue to do bad things. Now, remember what we have learned in the beginning of our study. The wilderness, being in a season of wilderness, it reveals hearts of men. So, ano po yung condition po ng ating puso? Kung ano po yung nasa sa loob po nun? What is hidden deep inside? Who we truly are? What we really feel like? That is gonna come out. Eventually, it will surface and lalabas po yun. Even through what we say or what we think, it reveals the hearts of men. Now, brothers and sisters, we cannot control what other people do to us. We cannot control or stop these bad people from doing bad things in our lives. But what we can do is we can control what is inside of us. Magpapa-apekto po ba tayo sa mga gagawin o ginawa na ng mga masamang tao po na ito, or are we gonna choose to be better? We need to put our trust and our faith in God. God is our shield. God is our protector. As we learn, moving onwards inside this verse. Now, verse 3 po, no? Kahit mapaligiran ako ng maraming kawal, hindi ako matatakot. Kahit salakayin nila ako, magtitiwala ako sa Diyos. So again, this concept of from being fearful to being faithful. He changed his mindset. David changed the condition of his heart. Instead of being fearful, he became faithful. Now, here's where it gets more interesting. Verse 4 po, isang bagay ang hinihiling ko sa Panginoon. Now, interesting enough, ano po kaya yung hihilingin ni King David in this, after this statement, after this phrase? Ano kaya yung ninanais niya, no? Nakalagay po doon, ito ang tanging ninanais ko. So, well, if you're surrounded by enemies, if you know that bad people will do bad things in your life, ano po kaya yung normal na iisipin po natin, no? Maybe we could think of a well-guarded house. Maybe we could think of bodyguards na talagang poprotektahan po tayo 24/7 na wala, hindi po nila hahayaan na may mangyari po sa atin or sa ating pong family. We could think of an increase in material wealth, syempre, dahil it protects us, kind of. The more wealthy you are, the more that you can afford lawyers, di po ba? So it's a kind of protection. Makikita rin po natin yun sa Bible. But is that what King David asked from God, even in this season na nararamdaman po niya na marami pong kaaway na gustong gawan po siya ng masama? So moving forward, ulitin ko po ulit, isang bagay ang hinihiling ko sa Panginoon, ito ang tanging ninanais ko, na ako'y manirahan sa kanyang templo habang ako'y nabubuhay, upang mamasdan ang kanyang kadakilaan at hilingin sa kanya ang kanyang patnubay. Brothers and sisters, this really reveals what is inside the heart of King David. He never wanted material wealth. He never wanted protection from, you know, men's protection. What he wanted was being in God's temple. And later on, we'll find out that this temple also shows that his desire is to be in God's presence. Now, how do I say so? Well, brothers and sisters, we're not just talking about a physical temple here, because as we read from the scriptures, in the life of King David, hindi naman po siya nanirahan 24/7, araw-araw, sa loob po mismo ng templo ng Diyos sa Jerusalem. But he had this desire to be in God's presence all the rest of his life. Now, brothers and sisters, again, if King David could have this heart na hindi po siya perfect, he makes mistakes, he made mistakes, but his desire is to be in God's presence, how much more could we ask of that from the Lord? Even in our homes right now, where you are sitting and watching this video, if we open up our hearts, hilingin lang po natin sa ating Panginoon, God, I want to be in your presence. Fill me with your presence right now. God can answer that. God can fulfill that. If you're driving, well, God's presence can fill you. If you're in the jeepney, in the bus, if you're walking, God can fill you with His presence. Now, my brothers and sisters, again, this is not being super spiritual. This is being in control of our emotions, brothers and sisters. But understanding that in every step that we make, wherever we are, if we desire to be in God's presence, God will allow it. What a wonderful God we serve, because He willingly blesses us with His presence. Moving onwards, no? Sa verse 5. Sa oras ng kagipitan ay itatago niya ako sa kanyang templo at ilalagay niya ako sa ligtas na lugar. Verse 6, kaya mananaig ako sa mga kaaway ko na nakapaligid sa akin. Maghahandog ako sa templo ng Panginoon habang sumisigaw sa kagalakan, umaawit at nagpupuri. Verse 7, dinggin niyo Panginoon ang aking pagtawag. Kahabagan niyo ako at sagutin ang aking dalangin. Panginoon, hinipo niyo ang aking puso na lumapit sa inyo, kaya narito ako, lumalapit sa inyo. Now, here's a result when God speaks to us. God touches our hearts. Hinihipo po niya ang puso, ang isipan ng bawat isa po sa atin. Now, there will be things that God will speak to us about. In this case, in King David, God wanted him to draw himself near to God, na lumapit siya sa Panginoon. But it could be different for you. You might be here right now, and while God is touching your life right now, He is giving you hope. He is encouraging you. Sinasabi po niya ngayon sa inyo, you can do it. You can be victorious. You can see the plans that He has for you being fulfilled. Na hindi po dahil sa nasa pandemic po tayo ngayon, na hindi na po matutuloy yung mga plano po niya sa buhay po natin. No, brothers and sisters, God is touching maybe the hearts of those who are listening right now, and He is bringing encouragement in your life. Now, maybe some of you, God is touching your heart. God is speaking to you right now, and He wants you to forgive someone. No? Forgive someone that has done you wrong. Now, again, that's not a very easy thing. We can easily forgive, but sometimes it's hard for us to forget or really forgive someone. And I'm gonna talk about forgiveness. It's gonna be a different topic on a different day. Pero maybe someone here right now, so you are listening, watching this video, God is touching your heart. And God wants you to forgive. God wants you to walk in forgiveness. And not in bitterness, not in anger. You may be here right now. No, instead of asking giving forgiveness or allowing forgiveness to reign into your heart, maybe you need to ask for forgiveness. You need to repent. No, brothers and sisters? Alalahanin po natin, there could be no repentance if there is no desire for you to repent. Right? So maybe someone here right now, God is touching your heart and God wants you to repent from your sins, to consider your ways. Isipin po ninyo ang nangyayari sa buhay po natin ngayon, and do you want to go and move forward? Are you gonna be stiff-necked? Are you gonna be stubborn and you're gonna say, no, I'm gonna do this, I want to do this? Or are you gonna allow God to touch your heart and you asking for forgiveness for your mistakes? You might be here and God is touching your heart and you are in need of guidance. Later on, we will be looking into God giving direction to our lives. But you may be here, a parent, a single mom, a father, or a mother, a student, and in this pandemic, you are kind of lost. You're a businessman, businesswoman. God wants to give guidance. God wants to touch your heart because He wants to give guidance into your life. Now, moving forwards, verse 9. Huwag niyo po akong pagtaguan. Ako na alipin niyo ay huwag niyong itakwil dahil sa inyong galit. Kayo na laging tumutulong sa akin, huwag niyo akong iwanan at pabayaan. O Diyos na aking tagapagligtas, iwanan man ako ng aking mga magulang, kayo naman Panginoon ang mag-aalaga sa akin. Ituro niyo sa akin ang daang gusto niyong lakaran ko. Now, here's another reason why we need to listen to God's voice, why we need to allow His touch, His leading in our lives. Because we need direction. We can choose to walk our way or we can choose to walk God's way. We can choose our plan. We can choose someone else's plan for us, or we can choose to listen and be a part of God's plan in our lives. Now remember, there are things that we think is the right thing to do, but with God, it's the opposite. Well, why do we need to choose? Why choose God's plan? Because it is complete. Brothers and sisters, yung pong plano po natin, it is based on man's wisdom, based on what we have experienced in the past, maybe someone else's experience. So we gather all of that information. We kind of, you know, compare it with how we are living today, the now. But then, wala pong kasiguruhan in the future. If those statistics, if those facts will be the same. But brothers and sisters, with God, He knows the now and He knows the future. Wow. So how can our plans be more stable than the plans that God has for us? Brothers and sisters, we need to trust that God's plans are better than our plans. Moving forward, patnubayan niyo ako sa tamang daan. Dahil sa mga kaaway ko na gusto akong gawan ng masama. Again, bad people doing bad things. And what are they doing? Well, huwag niyo akong ibigay sa aking mga kaaway dahil ako'y kanilang pinagbibintangan ng kasinungalingan at nais nilang ako'y saktan. Now, here are other things that bad people do to you. They want to hurt you. They want to, they spread lies about you. You're gonna be discouraged. You know, even in this season of being in the wilderness, you expect na parang ceasefire. You expect na, okay, peace, because we're all in this pandemic mode. We're kind of, you know, getting our resources together, focusing on what is important. But you know what? There will be bad people. And again, bad people will do bad things. We will be discouraged if we focus on these bad people. Focus on God. Focus on Him. And moving on, verse 13. Ngunit naniniwala ko na mararanasan ko ang kabutihan niyo, Panginoon, habang ako'y nabubuhay dito sa mundo. Wow, what a wonderful verse. Ngunit naniniwala ko na mararanasan ko ang kabutihan niyo, Panginoon, habang ako'y nabubuhay dito sa mundo. Now, I believe this is something that a lot of us here should be holding on throughout the season of being in the wilderness. Our faith that we will experience God's goodness while we are in this world, while we are in this pandemic. Even if we experience heartaches, God's goodness will sustain us. Even if we experience betrayal, God's goodness will sustain us. Now, if you think that you are being overwhelmed on each and every side, on the left, on the right, in the front, at the back, if you feel overwhelmed, you feel that your world is falling apart, God's goodness will lift you up, will sustain you. And as we close on this wonderful chapter, magtiwala kayo sa Panginoon, magpakatatag kayo, at huwag mawalan ng pag-asa. Ulitin ko po ulit because I believe this is a word for some of you, maybe all of you who are listening today. Magtiwala kayo sa Panginoon, magpakatatag kayo, at huwag mawalan ng pag-asa. Magtiwala lamang kayo sa Panginoon. Today, I just want to speak hope in your life right now. These are not my words, you know. These are not cleverly crafted words that I wanted to encourage you. But these are the words coming from the scriptures. These are not my words. These are the words that came out from God. He wants us to know that we can put our trust and our faith in Him. We can listen. We can be touched by God's presence. We can receive direction in our lives. Let us have attentive ears. Let us have open hearts. And let us be willing to allow God to change us.
Forget to like or share this page, this video to your friends, families, and loved ones para po patuloy tayo maging pagpapala sa ating mga mahal sa buhay. And as always, if you have any prayer requests, if you want someone to agree with you in prayer, please don't hesitate to send us a message and we will be happy to pray for you. And again, we hope to see you once again next Sunday. God bless!